Hello again everyone, today I am back with a new tutorial video. This time we will be building a simple activity in Discord. In case you didn't know, Discord has officially released the embedded app SDK, allowing the community to create their own activities. This is not a new feature at all because there are already activities like YouTube Together and Gartic Phone and much more. But now anyone can build an activity, which is why I wanted to share this tutorial. I will follow the Discord guide to create a simple Hello World activity that display the voice channel name. However, it's important to note that creating activity is still in the public developer preview. That means activities will only be playable in servers with 25 users or less. In-app purchases are not yet available in this developer preview. The activities cannot become verified. Existing verified apps cannot add activities during this developer preview. Let's get started. To begin, open the Discord developer platform and create a new application. Just choose a name for your app. Then go to OAuth2 and copy client ID and client secret. Save these in Notepad as we will need them later for creating our activity. Now specify a URL for authentication. I will just write localhost here. Oops, I forgot the slash. Save the changes. Now click on Getting Started in the Activity section and enable it. And we are done. For now, we don't need to change anything here. Now let's look at the guide. We have already completed these steps, so I will skip ahead. But I recommend going back to read the details to understand more if you are interested. So here Discord has prepared a project setup for us. It's available publicly in GitHub. I am going to download it via Git. But you can download it as a zip file of your prefer. Git clone and Ctrl V. Navigate to the folder and open VS Code here. So this is the server files, and these are the front-end files. The front-end is just a Vite project with vanilla JavaScript. I will open the terminal to install the front-end dependencies. First, navigate to the client directory, and then run npm install. Now run npm run dev to start it. Clearly, it's a simple Vite project that can run in a browser. Now we need to make it work on Discord as a real activity. Go back to the guide and paste this code into main.js in the client folder. And install the Discord embedded app SDK library. Run the app again. If we reload it, we'll just get a gray screen with nothing on it. This is because we add the Discord library, so the app now only works on Discord. Before testing it in Discord, we need to install cloudflared to make our local host accessible from anywhere. This is the official cloudflared GitHub page. You can find the link in the description. Go to the assets and select the right one for your system. For Windows users, I recommend this one. I have already installed cloudflared in my computer, so I will skip this step. After installing the cloudflared, copy this URL and open a new terminal to run the flown command. Cloudflared tunnel --url and Ctrl V. Wait a moment. Scroll up a bit and you will see a new URL for you. Copy it. Let us test it in the browser. As you can see, this points to the localhost front end project, but it works everywhere, not just in your computer. Now go back to the activity settings. Click on URL mappings and paste it here. Before testing our activity, make sure to enable the developer mode. Go to the Discord settings and click on Advanced and enable this option. After joining the voice channel, you will see your activity here. Wait a bit. And here we go, this is our Hello World activity. Now we need to add authorization so we can access the guild and channel info and even the participants in our activity. Let's go back to the guide. Scroll to here and copy all of this. And paste it in the front end main file here. Now let me explain the code a bit. This is the setup desktop SDK function. Here we wait for the Discord SDK, or actually the activity, to be ready for use. After that, we send an authorize command to Discord with our client ID and the needed scopes. Then we make a request to our server with the derived code. The API thing here is a proxy configured with Vid. If you go to vid.config.js, you will see the /API points to the localhost 3001. Now I think we need to run the server. Navigate to the server directory and install the dependencies with npm install. Let's run it now. And this is the server running on port 3001, exactly as configured here. If you look at the server main file, you will see a simple backend app made with Express.js. It has a post request handler. Here, the server verifies the authorization code using the ID and secret code, then responds with the access token. Now, we need to reopen the activity again. And wait a bit. I guess I made a mistake. My bad, I forgot about the env file. Just paste the client ID and client secret, that we save it in Notepad. Rename it to env. Reload the server. Now let's see if it works. It's working fine, just click to authorize. We've authorized it, but actually nothing will appear here. So let's try to show the voice channel name. Go back to the guide and copy this function. Go to the main file of a client directory and paste it here. I don't like this order of functions, so I am going to move this down. Here we call the function that we just pasted. So how does it work? After authorization, we check if the guild and channel are not null. Then we send a Discord SDK comment to get the channel info. With its ID here. If a channel name is not null, we store it in this variable. Finally, we create a PHTML element and append it to our app. Let's see the result. And this is a hello world with activity channel name. And we have finished developing our activity in this video. I want to mention that the Discord documentation has a lot of information. You can browse it and learn more. You can also find examples to start with, like the SDK playground, dealing with multiplier and state management, etc. They are also available in GitHub. If you like this video, I might make a playlist to build a complete game in Discord activity. So stay tuned. Thank you for your watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like and share, and see you in the next video.